Who you gonna call? Ghostbuster!
Right, so... Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Right, so, this is the next part. I don't know what the numbering is. It's obviously all just recorded at the one time, and then I'm going to split it up. So this is the second part of the big update, showing you all the things that are going on. Yay! Next is the... HGA, I think it's called. So that's this. This is the shape, basic shape of the white bit is styrene, and the inside's obviously foam. That's obviously a Pringles tube. These are the bottle caps from bottles of vitamins, and I stuck them, well I tried, I was going to stick them on and I thought I've not got a huge amount of surface area to stick them on. So like these other little knobs, these are just bottle caps, I filled them in with putty. Obviously that needs sanded smooth, and I did the same on these ones, and then that means there's a much larger surface area to glue them on, because obviously everything's hanging like this off of the proton pack, so it all needs to be pretty secure. Next is the bit that's name I can't remember. It's like a something, that's not the filter, that's on the, I can't remember what it's called. I'll show a diagram in the pack to show what it is. But basically it's like a little kind of small circular thing, which is actually this, which is the bit of the bottle from which those caps came from, these caps. Just cut in half, filled up with foam, top half putty, that needs sanded obviously, and then I'm just going to stick one of these washer guys on for a bit of detail and some other bits and pieces. These all have tubes coming out of them and stuff like that. So that's that. This is the iron arm, so it kind of looks like a bit like a child's drawing of a car. This is made out of styrene, and the insides are filled with foam, as you'll see. This sits off the pack kind of like that, and then there's a bit that's going to get, a bit of wood that's going to get screwed onto the top part here, and that's when like the actual metal arm hangs off of, and that kind of thing. So this is quite sturdy, needs to be, because it's going to stick quite far out of the pack, so I'm probably going to bolt this to another bit of plastic and then bolt that to the wood, just to make it all a bit more secure. The top of the HGA filter has a crankshaft on it, which was another bottle cap, the nipple, I believe it is called, of a sports drink, lovely blue drink, and just some styrene plastic that I stuck together, and that's ended up looking like this. And obviously the another bit there go there, and it's got all like the nice detail on it to make it look like it could actually crank in some way, and obviously that'll all get painted. That's all the, or most of the little components and stuff like that that go into the pack. The big bits, the three main bits, is obviously the Alice frame, the actual motherboard with the pack on it, and the cyclotron. So for the cyclotron, I'm not sure if I've got much in the way of pictures of that, although I did have a film of it. I'll see if I can find what I've done with that. Basically that was a microwave plate cover, because that turned out to be the exact size and dimensions that I needed, and I spent ages working out how I would cut holes in it that looked okay, so that where the red lights could shine through, and then realised, no, it's clear, I don't need to cut holes in it at all. But I'd spent so long working this out, but I didn't cut holes in it. So all I've done is I have got washers of a kind of decent size, glued them on in the pattern that it needs to be, and painted the clear plastic behind that red, and mounted the LEDs inside their own little kind of light box, like saying light boxes, it's cardboard glued into a tube covered in gaffer tape. I've glued them in and inserted the LEDs in there and then glued it behind it. And I've left that test running for a wee while and it looks pretty good and does the job. And I cut a section out of it and used half a tube of Pringles, or not less than half a tube of a Pringle bit, cut that out and cut the holes in it, paper macheed it so it's a bit stronger and kind of glued it to the side. So we'll show you that. So this is the cyclotron. It doesn't look like much at the moment, so there's the filter. So the inside, there's the LEDs around there. All these wires will get tidied up. That is a bit of dowling rod attached into there. I just thought that will give it a bit of extra support. I've left the middle clear for reasons that will become apparent in a second. And that's what it will look like. Obviously it will get painted. These will remain red. There was holes in it, or dimples in it, that I've filled up with putty. And all these other little holes. Once I give it a coat of primer, it will probably need bits and pieces sanded and putted, that kind of thing. For the rest of it, So for the bumper that goes around the back, I spent ages figuring out how I would do this, and I decided that the best way would be to get a big length of kind of PVC plastic that's quite flexible and try and create the shape of that, and because it's got these ridge details and stuff like that. And in the middle section I thought I could create a sheet of styrene and try and get it to bend and shape properly. And I looked into it and then I realised it actually would just be cheaper to buy someone's 3D printed version of eBay than to buy all the bits and then have to make it. So that's what I did. I cheated. So here are the legs for the bumper. These are, and the benefit of having these made is they're nicely detailed already. I don't need to do any of the work. Just need to paint them. There's a middle bit that's sitting somewhere. Paint them, stick them on, and that'll go. And then for the middle, there is, this will stick up at the middle of the proton pack. This is the shock mount. So that is a bunch of washers all glued together. That's obviously a bit of glue sticking out that I'll need to scrape off. These are all just glued together on a bit of dowling rod that obviously we cut the tops and bottoms of that, and that will go right through the middle of the cyclotron and down into the hole in the motherboard, and will therefore provide it with like a bit of strength holding everything in together. So that's that. So the main concern with all of this stuff is that it's going to sit on the pack upright, which means that gravity will be acting on all of it all the time. So most of the pieces, whilst they're getting glued to the motherboard, most of them are also going to get screwed on, nailed in or bolted on, so that they're all really sturdy. So I've made some changes to the motherboard and the Alice frame since they were last on the video. I realised that for the motherboard, the measurements for the iron arm and for the HGA are just for those parts, whereas the motherboard itself actually is kind of raised a good bit so that they sit on it. Without that, they're all far too sunken in. So I created a wooden box for the pit that the iron arm is going to attach to. It's wooden because I want it to be very sturdy, so that, because the iron arm, the whole bit sticks out quite far. So I want that to be super sturdy. The bit that the HGA Pringles tube part rests on doesn't need to be all that sturdy, so that's just foam. So I shall get the board now. This is what we're looking at here. So if I can get this up. This is the motherboard in its entirety. So I've cut out this hole in the middle, as you can see, so that I'm going to be cutting holes in these bits so that wires can run through. And here's the bits I've added. So that's wood and that's foam with plastic on top. and it's obviously going to get sanded a lot more. These bits here are places. There we go. Are places that I have identified as where bolts are going to go to attach the Alice frame. Speaking of which, so I built a new Alice frame. The last one was a bit squinty and wasn't all that happy with it. So I built this one and it's a lot straighter and sturdier, and I've already painted it, obviously. I'll need touch-ups because I drilled holes in it for where the pack's going to mount. And obviously that's got scuffed up as I was testing things. So this is the new Alice frame. I'm going to attach the straps to that, and I've got a bit of foam that will go over there. But it's looking pretty good. And I've test fitted the pack on it, and it all sits pretty nicely. So that is everything so far. That's all the components, the motherboard and the Alice frame. So the next part is sanding that bit on the motherboard, tidying up all the detail on it, and then basically painting all the parts and tidying up all the detail on them, getting, you know, the primer and the base coat on it. Quite a lot of them will also need adhesion promoter, because quite a lot of them are made up of different materials, some of which paint bonds to better than the others. Obviously I'm going to leave the bottom of all of them paint free, so I get a better adhesion when I glue them onto the wood of the motherboard. And then once all the parts are on, including the cyclotron, the cyclotron, I need to run wires from all the different places that need electricity, and down out of the hole that I'm going to make in the cyclotron for where the hose is going to attach, so that again, because there'll be switches on the thrower that control the lights on the pack. But I've got enough wire for all that. That's the next part, sticking it all and painting it. And then is all the different types of tubing and hosing that gets on stuck onto the pack, and the ribbon cable and the clamp for the ribbon cable that I've not made yet. The tubing part is like, you know, an hour job. It's not very long. And then that'll be pretty much the pack then. And then it'll be focusing on making the thrower, which shouldn't be too hard. I've got most of the materials already. The tubes that I used for the bottom of the power cell, they're the same width as for the kind of tubes of the thrower. So it's just the kind of main box to make, and then obviously wiring all that and getting all the lights and that set up. So the next video will probably have it all painted and stuck together, maybe. Who knows?